It is certainly my pleasure to have our Attorney General here. One of your first stops, I would say, since you've been sworn in, and I would love to have you say a few words to my team and yours.
Okay. Well, thank you so much, Madam Mayor, for your leadership over the last several weeks, but also over the last several months. I have watched you work very hard to bring back some hope and peace to the city that I know that you love and that you are clearly committed to. It's been really a pleasure and an honor to have the Department of Justice team working with you and your staff over the last few weeks, and also over the last few months as we've dealt with a number of the issues facing Baltimore. This is one of my first visits as Attorney General. I'm delighted that it's here to Baltimore, and where we have such willing partners in the effort to improve this beautiful city. So I want to thank you on behalf of my staff for all that you and your staff have done to smooth our way, mm-hmm. to give us the support that we need as we try and provide help and resources to you. And I commit to you that that work will not end.
Thank you. I want to thank you again for being here and tell you that you are incredibly well served by your team that has been on the ground in Baltimore. We know that what we saw in Baltimore over the past 2 weeks is it's happening in Baltimore, but it's a symptom of something that's going on all over the country, where there is a growing divide between the police and the community. And it's something that I have been very concerned about and have worked on this issue for years. But we know that there are some foundation issues that have to be in place before we can rebuild that trust. And I appreciate the collaborative reform that we have been engaging in, and I look forward to talking to you about more opportunities that we can strengthen that work, because we cannot afford to fail. I believe that the relationship between the police and the community is like a marriage, and separation is not an option. Divorce is not an option. We have to figure out how we're going to make this marriage work and make it healthy and make it thrive so our city can thrive. So I'm grateful to have your team here and to work with you as we continue to build the trust and have a safer city, because I believe what happens here can be a signal for what's possible in other places around the country. So I want to thank you for your partnership.
Absolutely. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Paul. You can come in.